professor, and her research topic is a critical study of lactate sanskrit text manushmriti with special reference to gender inequality. Is that right?
Yeah,
thank you. Good luck.
Very good afternoon to all of you. Respected chair of the session, research scholar, and my colleague. I am Dr. Kaushalya, known as Dr. Kaushal Pama, assistant professor in Department of Sanskrit, Motilal Nehru College, University of Delhi, India. Today, I want to present my paper on Acharya Manu Dharma Shastra and Hindu Code Bill, a critical study of selected Sanskrit text Manusmriti with special reference to gender inequality. I have authored many books based on gender discrimination.
Microphone.
Where is the mic? Can I repeat again my topic?
Yes. Acharya Manu Dharma Shastra and Hindu Code Bill, a critical study of selected Sanskrit text with Manusmriti is its special reference to gender inequality. I describe my topic based on discrimination in Dharma Shastra. You can say theology of Dharma Shastra. In Indian context, we call theology Dharma Shastra. And I used many times that theology, you understand Dharma Shastra. I have authored many books on gender inequality in Dharma Shastra literature. It's my publication. Outline of my presentation is introduction of Dharma Shastra literature, and after that I would like the subject of Manusmriti and daily life of Sudras in Dharma Shastra. Another one, the status of Indian women in Dharma Shastra. In that subtopic, I would like to share with you within Dalit, within women, what is the status of Dalit women. And we find the word Shudra, that is called in modern time Dalits. And I would like to share with you what is the position of women within women, Dalit women, what is the position of Dalit women. And after that, Hindu Code Bill, written by Babasaheb Bhimrao Ambedkar in Constitution. The special provision made for women, Dr. Ambedkar Constitution. And after that, I would like to conclude my paper. Let's start with introduction of Smritis. Manusmriti is composed of Vedas and it is also subject of investigation. It's in that human being is unable to understand the deep subject described in the Vedas. Therefore, the knowledge of the Vedas in Smritis has been explained in detail. The deep knowledge described in the text has been explained in detail in Smritis. Therefore, the deep knowledge prescribed in Vedas was preserved in memoranda even in an easy language. Brahma gave his Manas and Manu in 1 lakh verses to the teaching of the religion contained in Vedas. The divine man gave the birth to Manu with great assurity and with the whole world. The man gave the birth to 10 devotees, Marichi, Angira, Bhrigu, Narada. That is the follower of Manusmritis. And then all these together gave birth to 7 human. Thus, in the 7 other mythological traditional, 14 Manas was famous. The composition written by Manu is called Manusmriti itself. Its language style and then sometimes it is to be similar to Mahabharata. This is also called human Dharma Shastra. There are many reasons for the premeditativeness of Manusmriti, but due to the meaning of the Vedas, its recognition is more. It has been interpreted in 4 commentaries. Many commentators have been written on this due to the importance of humankind. The name of Medhatithi, Kuluk Bhatt, Govindacharya have been taken in its famous writing. But in all this, the main place of Kuluk Bhatt is special reference of Manvarth Muktavali, Hemant. Maitratriti is the oldest commutator of Manusmriti, the most common from the Manvart Muktavali is simple, short and clear. I would like to share, my presentation is based on primary resource of the Vedas. And after that, I would like to research on the writing of Vedas, then Dharmashastra. And
can you just clarify, since this is an international group?
Yeah.
And I'm sorry, I'm not sure from which religion are you talking? Is this the Hindu language?
Yeah, of course, Hindu language.
You are talking about Hinduism?
Yeah. Hinduism and Sanskrit texts.
And what are these sub levels that you are discussing?
I'm discussing my research based on Hindu religion, Dharmashastra, and Vedas, Brahman, Aranyaka, Upanishad, Vedant, and after that, Manusmritis. I focus only Manusmriti.
In one sentence, tell us the difference between these dimensions.
Okay. Actually, our Hindu religion, word remain after long ago. But when we talk about the Vedic period, about the gender discrimination is less than after the Manusmritis. That's why I clearly focus my research on Dharmashastra Smritis. But we divide the four parts of Sanskrit Hindu literature, that is called Ved, Brahman, Aranyak, Upanishad and Vedanta. Time to time that Hindu text is written in Hindu literature. You may call it Hindu theology. And I focused on woman perspective. What is the source of discrimination in socially, politically, culturally, economically, or we can say the position or the what is the position of woman in Hindu text? I call Dharmashastra. Now maybe it is clear, or shall I start? A second point of my presentation is Hindu code bill.
It's a feminist approach or feminist reading of your Bible.
Yeah. Or you can say Bible. But we always called Dharmashastra, theology, you can say. And not only I focus the feminine position in Dharmashastra. Rather than I want to explain what is the position of lower caste woman in Dharmashastra literature, because when I am assistant professor in Sanskrit literature, Dharmashastra literature, I have written research on that topic. But I found even the woman position is we can say not high position, but rather than deprived section woman, there is a discrimination between women also in the literature. That's why I took the topic. And in Indian context, we always research on Vedic literature or Dharmashastra, but we do not want to, as a Sanskrit teacher, we do not want to question that within female, what is the position of deprived section woman? That's why I took the topic.
So it's a study between the castes as well?
Yeah, you can say. Between caste, within castes.
Can I clear out here a bit? I think I talked about...
I request the chair give me extra time for my presentation.
I just want to clear out with the listener what she's trying to say is a religious perspective.
Yeah, religious perspective.
The women,
yes,
in the religion. Mm. And yesterday I had talked a little bit about the Hindu religious system where we have a caste system, different castes. So in a different caste, upper caste, lower caste, and she's talking, focusing more on the lower caste, women. women itself is deprived, but again, the women from the lower class, inside the women.
Double deprivation.
Yes, yes, that's what she's trying to find. So, over here you see the Brahmin, there is a priest. A priest, warrior, merchant, and the commoner. So divided in a four section. So the priests are the top level, and the warriors, kings, even the kings are the second level. And the third comes to the merchant, who are the business or the land owners, and again the lower, the commoner, and others. So it's divided in a different section. And then she is trying to put the lower caste women in this system.
Thank you so much, sir, for helping me. Thank you. Taking the opportunity, what is the subject matter of Manusmriti? The sense of Manu, which has been applied in the literature and society in the form of ancient ethics. In Manusmriti, Manu has explained the Vedas as the root of the knowledge, clarifying that Kashchid Kashche Dharmo Manuna Mani Prakrita Sa Sarva Abhito Vede Sarva Gyanam Hiso. Manusmriti has 12 chapters and 2694 verses, which have been streamed in the simple style. Its grammar is also mostly according to Panini. Its doctrine met Gautama Buddha Apastam Dham Sutra. Many of verses are also found in Vishnu Sahita, Vaisishtha Dhamsutra, whatever the religion has been said by Manu, all the religion have been said in Vedas, that Manu is the knower of the meaning of all the Vedas. In the evidence of the moments of the Vedas, natural religion and principle, the Manusmriti proved not only for one country, but for the world, as written by Manusmriti. Which was also spread abroad outside in India. Maharishi Manu had knowledge of literature from his past. It is the origin of the creation is described as Tasya so arnishya shantam prasute prati buddhyate prati buddhas srijati mana sada sadatamakaham. Here the Dharmashastra is described as subject matter of Manusmriti explained description of celibacy, description of duty, non-fervity, description of graduation, marriage and work, describe the panchagavya of household, describe of the homestead, describe the description of sanitary, description of purification and description of family religion. The description of varna prastha, sannyasashastram, statement of the state, rajadharma, state penalty statement, description of the power styled woman, description of the defenses and description of the practice. For example, description of the quadrennial instinct, describe the pattern of the religion, description of the atonement, significance of tenancy, and the description of the fruit. Describe the auspicious karma and idolatrous pattern, man of the religion I described. According to P.V. Karne, the first edition of Manusmriti in India came out in 1830, which was derived from Calcutta. After this, there are so many versions of the Manusmriti that it is not possible to give the name. Manusmriti has also been translated into English, in which Buller's translation is considered best. If you want to read the old situation of Indian theology, you can English translation of Buller, that is the best. I can recommend that. Then now. What is the daily life of Sudras in Dharmashastra written? After being completely innocent of a characterization in the society, social stratification has an important role in determining the Brahman's superiority. How one character can be superior to any other character and how to maintain its supremacy, it is necessary for the right of the one's right and disposition of the others on the social, religious and economic resource. Apart from this stratification of religious and economic activities, which are being edited in the society, also plays a key role in it. This is the reason that the implementation of the superiority by the study and uplift of the Vedic took a specific status in the society, and other excluded deeds were non-specified and some were declared untouchable in the long run. On the one hand, according to the scholars, teaching of the Brahman and Sudras are a significant part of the knowledge of Athar Veda and in the Quran Mantra lesson. It is said that Shudra is called the monopoly. On the other hand, the Dharma Shastra also established that knowledge which is in the woman and Shudras is the ultimate limit of their education. Only after acquiring the knowledge of it, the knowledge of all the knowledge is complete. It is clear that while having the respect for all the action excluded, these beliefs are inherent in the principle of integrity and thus the process of stratification begins. In some ways, some activities considered sacred have been arranged for the deprivation of Shudras and they are forced to move down in social stratification. The concept of character was dependent on many factors such as idea of Ashoka, which can separate to the social platform, clear division of the labor and expected extras in. Differences among the trade and differences between the ethnic and regional population. Upanayana have played an important role in social stratification. Upanayana is the beginning of the taking the education. In Hindu mythology or in Hindu Dharma Shastra, Upanayana Sanskara is must to achieve the education. And I will describe one thing also. In four Varna, Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra, that you have seen first slide, Brahmana, Kshatriya and Vaishya, the right to achieve the Upanayana Sanskara start their education. But in the lower caste of Shudras, or you may say untouchable, they do not have right to acquire the education through Upanayana Sanskara. That's why I take that topic. I can share with Vedas have called for all human beings. Vedas consider Yathemam Vacham Kalyani, Ma Vadani Janebhya, Ma Rajanya Bham, Sudraya Cha Aryaya Cha Swa Achanaya. Veda is considered that Shudra Varna is also right to find, to acquire the knowledge. But before the time passed, Dharma Shastra beyond that, Shudra and Shudra women also not to have right to acquire the education. Divine instruction is that scholar like a priest to Veda, to Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra. Even if you do this seems that Shudra had the right to sacrifice, but studying Upanayana and Vedic literature of Shudras are prohibited by coming up to the Dharma Shastra and Samritis. Except for the Shudra Varna, except for those who do misreads, deputation, the study of Vedas and transformation of the fire have been prescribed for the rest and their deeds are also giving the virtue to the people and the world. Kamalakar Bhatt, quoting from the Taittiriya courses, even after joining in the character of Shudras, there is a word of condemnation of deeds by karma and it is known to be justice comfortable. In the same way, it is decided that feet are the Samshana, who is a Shudra, who sacrificed with feet. That is, now feet are movable. For this reason, Shudra do not speak in yajna, nor does call to God. Dharmacharya believes that child is not worshipped, he is the free from yajna foundation. He is being considered as somebody of the Vedas until involved. Kamalakar Bhatt, a research scholar on Shudra Anikam, cites the Harivar commentary of Nag Dev Vahinikam Vaishadev Yajna. For the twins, as said in the morning and evening, so the Shudras are only in the day, not in the evening. Although Shudras do not have the right to edit, Shudras is also preferred by the Vartanushtana from the time of the divine early past. Regarding the establishment of God, it was said in Shudra that when there is a ritual arrangement by the respected gender monogamous, then even the Shudra and the woman should not touch it. It has been said that in the absence of Vaigya words and tone, nor to the Shudras study. There is a clear mention in the scripture that making and offering yajna are done only for the souls having the karmic right. And the reproduction can be taken from Shudra even with the birth of a lover. The way Vedas are not pronounced near such slave, just as the Vedas cannot be adjustment to the symmetry. They are poor from away. Thus it is clear that Shudra and the determinant wrongdoing were engaged for deprivation and study of Vedic. And thus, this position in social stratification was made in lower order. This system also provides the harsh social mobility. It has been arranged that Shudra is the fourth character. It is of a caste. That is not Kvandrajal of Upadhyan Sanskara like the other three characters. Downward mobility has been enacted in Manusmriti, and by division of the verb, division of the verb superiority and uncertainty have also been mentioned on the social activity, that which neither man sleep in the night nor in the evening. To take out of the board of the double-minded deeds like Shudra, he who qualified and does not study the Vedas and work hard in the other scripture. He lives with the family who becomes Shudra. The situation which was apparently being Shudra in form of destructive living, while the woman also had the situation. Then coming out of my presentation, what is the status of woman in Dharmashastriya literature? The Brahminical ideology has been instrumental in placing the violence and harassment of Dalits in India, and this ideology has been recognized and given sanctity of our religion and Puran. As mentioned in one of the religion Hyman, if the Shudra male dares to touch a Brahmin lady, his particular body part organ should be cut off from his body. If a Brahmin male happens to rape a Shudra woman, he should be allowed to go after playing tilak on his forehead. Nationalist historians such as A.S. Altaker have considered Vedic age to be the glorious period for the status of the woman in the Indian society. It has been said that like a man, a woman was allowed to participate and platform in yajna, she should also create richa. However, it was beyond the reach of Shudra's woman to do the same in the Vedic society. The exploitation of the Shudra woman was a common feature of the society, which was continued to this day also. It has been said in Kathak Sahita, a sage while worshipping the Indra prays to him as follows: "Hey Indra, if the Shudra woman tries to wander, you punish her by platting with stone in order to protect the glorious religion of the Aryan. It is a common knowledge that a man implements the fetus in her body. However, according to Hindu religion, it is the man's body where the fetus first gets produced in form of sperm. Therefore, it is the man who becomes the protector of the sperm inside his body. By collectivating the sperm within him and giving the shape of his sperm to be produced as a fetus post-copulation. Thus, the man is called the first creator of the being. In a particular case of unity of the woman has been completely neglected, overlooked, injustice. Tilak ke saath parant, woman should follow the karma as is been dictated, but these should be without recitation of any mantra. Their marriage sanskara should be conducted on the line of the Upadhyan sanskara, according to which sanctity of their marriage will be take the sanctity of anything solemnized by a young. Their duties towards their husband will become their gurukul nivas. Their domestic duties will be take a performance of yoga. It becomes clear that women had no rights of Upadhyan sanskara to gain education. For them, their duty towards the husband would be their obedience toward the religion, and thus the best education for them. Since ages, woman overall personality development has suffered the burden of the psychology of establishment herself as an entity. There are many examples I have quoted from Dharmashastra. Now I would like only 1 minute double discrimination of the woman. Within Dalits, there are also a discrimination within Dalits also. There is a community like Valmiki community. This community discriminated by the Dalit woman also. That is the focus point of my presentation also. You can say that's time, and I have short time, so I am skipping all these things. Now, what is the Hindu Court Bill in Indian society? Hindu Court Bill in Indian society made by Dr. Babasaheb Bhimrao Ambedkar to secure and give their right to in the constitution, so that nobody in Indian society can deny their rights, whether it is woman, whether it is Dalit woman, whether it is Dalit or whether it is upper caste woman. So what is the special provision made for women in the Dr. Ambedkar constitution are as follows. Eliminating the tradition of the multiple wives and giving women imaging respect. In the case of the first legal wife marriage, the second wife marriage was invalid. Like this, and daughter also have given the provision of authority in the conclusion of the of her father. Gave the right to adoption, gave the right to divorce, gave the right, daughter right to become meher, gave the right to get equal pay as man for the equal work. Provided right to get back according to the woman ability. Ban on woman working in the underground coal mines. Handed gender discrimination, child marriage ban, ban on prostitution, right to freedom of religion, gave the right to vote, opened the door for the woman to become prime minister and president. Gave the right to live life with human dignity. Now I would like to conclude my paper. In all these provisions, not only for Shudra woman has been barred as impure, but by prescribing the marriage of a woman of a lower varna with a man of high varna, the caste system is sought to be strengthened and institutionalized. Thus, the Shudra woman not only the pollutes varna based superiority, but she is subordinate to Shudra man too. Thus, subject her dual subordinate. I will just explain last paragraph. Today, the women of India, women of India, social, business, economic, educational, religious, MPs in parliament, students in municipality, member of municipal corporation, lawyers, etc., etc., etc. But Baba Saheb Bhimrao Ambedkar only going to be formed those who supported the woman in the Indian constitution by giving equal right to equality, which no citizen of India can deny. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you very much.
But you didn't give me extra time.
I did. I gave you an extra 5 minutes.
Oh, thank you so much. Thanks. Now the floor is open.
Any feedback for her?
Do you have any questions? Lots of questions, I think.
Dilip Jal will help me.
Any clarification?
Just wind
up in your own words.
Could you summarize for us?
Yes.
Please?
Yeah, okay. There was some feedback for you, ma'am.
Yes, please.
When you come to the international forum to present and you're using the words, well-known words in Indian society, people over here that don't understand what word that you are using.
Okay.
So the definition of the word they don't know.
Right, so that's why it's a difficulty is to understand what you are saying. The concept itself is very huge and it's impactful. It's all the drama since in a society since a long time going on. So you are highlighting these dramas over here. But again, I think I touched some of this caste system yesterday and talked about. There is a caste system which is very difficult to break it. It will not break it in a soon time. It will take long and long and long time. Why? Because there are different situations over there. It has to go through the government to make the regulation, but the implementation is difficult part. Making a constitution is the one thing that you put 100 or 200 people in the room and then you identify and define the rules and regulation, giving the rights to the women. But when it comes to the implication, who is implementing it? Again, this Brahmin is implementing. So they will put the constitution away and they said, well, whatever, I don't care. How many Brahmin are you going to put in a jail?
You have no untouchable in the government?
No, we have now. So the government has made another regulation on that, on the constitution that is called reservation. So they put the reservation seats for the people, untouchable people, to come on their seats. Nobody can go over there. Doesn't matter if this person is qualified enough to go in that position or not. And that's a different situation again, which is a questionable whether this is a right decision to take these people.
No, sorry.
So we are going beyond that one.
I am interpreting with that reservation question. Actually, reservation is not a question to solve the caste system. That is only remaining part of the society can get something. And it's not meaning that they did not qualify that that requirement. They fulfill the requirement. After that, they get the reservation. And reservation is not the ultimate solution of the demolish the caste system. That's one thing I want to conclude.
Right. No, so yeah. Reservation was something beyond the research that I was giving the person. So her research that she has presented is about the women who are defined as a lower caste women and the double standard in the society from the upper caste. So in a poor section, three sections are allowed to do something, but the lower section is not allowed to do anything. So what she was presenting there, like the women. If women touch any upper caste people, her hands or organs, whatever is touching, will be chopped off. That was in beginning, not the last time, but long time ago, maybe century or two century or three century years ago. But now it's not that much. But the upper caste people who rape the women, lower caste women, they will be praised. That's what she was trying to say. That's a double standard. But now I think this is not still the rape.
Still is going on.
The rape situation is still there. That you come sometime in the news that you may have international news as well, right? So it's not only now the situation has changed, right?
A little bit changes. Only constitution reservation of the constitution.
Right. So there are rules and regulations in the constitution has formed for the lower caste people and the women. Itself, then after women from the Dalit, so there are things worth having over there, but implementation is another research for you to go on whether it is being implied or not.
Actually, we demand the new female policy so that we can change the mindset of the people. Thank you so much
Thank you. So, in order to keep an eye on our time, we've decided to break for lunch now, and we have one final presentation for Jolanda after lunch. So we'll have a group photograph if you follow Mr. Singh like we did yesterday, and I will lock up the room. Take your valuables, but you can leave your belongings. When we come back, we'll have lunch here again, and 1:45.